Just because of the blood is shed for you, and the blood he gave for your redemption, that is the sin that sets you free. Redemption from slavery. The slavery of sin, you're free. The slavery of sickness, you're free. The slavery of a yoke, you're free. And then the Habali said, you know, your father, your mother, or somebody, your relative, you know, came to do something and they didn't pay the money they ought to pay. And he says, okay, I know what I will do. All his children, all his relatives, I'm going to tie them down. I'm going to give them this. They'll never make progress. As I try to make progress like this, the chain of the Habalis on your leg is not allowing you to make progress. And now redemption day has come. I'm talking to somebody there. Redemption day has come. All those chains are broken in Jesus' name. Redemption from slavery. Look at Hebrews chapter 9. I'm reading from verse 12. And everything comes through the blood of Jesus. Hebrews chapter 9. I'm reading from verse 12. Here it says, neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood. That's Jesus Christ. That's your Savior. That's your Lord. That's your Redeemer. That's your Deliverer. That's the one that has come to set you free from every form of slavery. It says, by his own blood, he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained temporary redemption, having obtained short-term redemption, having obtained, tell me, eternal redemption for us. And you know, it says in the first, through his blood, redemption from slavery. Everything that has held you back, everything is broken. And it is because of his blood. By the way, no 3 points today, 7 points today. I said 7 points today. Because this is a limo shot now. I have to give 7 points instead of three. Praise the Lord. Because, you know, a sevenfold miracle coming upon your life. A sevenfold deliverance coming upon your life. Number one is the mercy. You are getting mercy today. And number two is inheritance. You are having inheritance today. Number three is redemption. Thank God you are redeemed. I wish I could come there and shake your hand because I'm so happy for you, because in your heart you are free. In your spirit you are free. In your body you are free. Go back to that business tomorrow. The people that are not coming to buy and they tie them down tomorrow, they'll be rushing and rushing and rushing. Because redemption has come, and all the goodness of God in your life, they will multiply in Jesus' name. You know, you had that migraine headache or whatever, tonight you're free. It's like cool air is blowing upon your head. Everything is now all right. All the palpitation of the heart, I see you there. Everything is gone now. And the heart that is doing like this, as if the heart will jump out, God has said, peace be still. Because redemption has come. I have it. I said I have it. You will never be the same again in Jesus' name. Number four, atonement for your soul. Atonement for your soul. You see, it's the blood of Jesus Christ that brings this atonement. We're looking at Leviticus chapter 17. Leviticus chapter 17, and I'm reading from verse 11. Leviticus chapter 17, it's the blood that grants you atonement. We're looking at chapter 17, and in verse 11, it says, for the life of the flesh is in the blood. The life of the flesh is in the blood, and I have given it to you upon the altar. To make, and tell me, an atonement for your soul. For it is the blood that maketh atonement for the soul. It is the blood that maketh atonement for the soul. You know what that means? It's like, you know, I don't know what is happening. Heaven is angry at the sinner every day. I don't know what is happening. It's like the angels are angry at the sinner every day. I don't know what is happening. It's like the whole of heaven is angry. I go this way, I see the smoke of the anger. I go that way, I see the fury of the anger. It's like everything blocks my way. And then somebody told you, why don't you make atonement? You say, what does that mean? He says, go and make a sacrifice. But the Lord will not accept an animal sacrifice. He will not accept a fowl as a sacrifice. What sacrifice will I make? He says, look at him on the cross. His name is Jesus. And then look at him as he shed his blood. They put a crown of thorns on him. They pierced his side. And then the blood came out. And it is that blood that makes atonement for your soul. And all the fury of heaven, all the anger of heaven against your life, all that anger is gone. God then says, I'm not your judge anymore, I'm your father. I'm the lover of your soul. Because atonement has been made, you can now go with peace of mind. Being justified freely by his grace, we have peace with God. Look at this, Romans chapter 5, the blood that makes the atonement. Atonement for your soul. We're looking at Romans chapter 5. In Romans chapter 5, I'm reading from verse 8. Romans chapter 5, we're looking at verse 8. Here is it. Romans chapter 5, and we're reading from verse 8. It says in verse 8, but God commendeth his love towards me. God commendeth his love towards me. That's why he's preparing a place for you in heaven. You thought you were bad. He says Jesus Christ has paid your penalty. Jesus Christ has removed your guilt. And Jesus Christ is thinking well of you. But God commendeth his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Much more than being now justified by, tell me out loud. By his blood. Do you see that the atonement is the blood? It's the blood of Jesus. Be not justified by his blood. We shall be saved from wrath through him. For if when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his son, much more being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. Look at verse 11. And not only so, but we also joy, we rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom we have received, tell me, the atonement. That means then he has totally quenched all the fury, all the fire, all the anger, all the smoke of his judgment against your life. Because of the blood, because that's what it says in verse 9, much more than being now justified by his blood. You see, mercy for every sinner, it comes through that blood. Inheritance of the saints, it comes through that blood. And redemption that gets you out of slavery, it comes through that blood. Atonement for your soul, that there's no anger over your life anymore, and you have the peace of God now, it comes through the blood of the Lamb. Number 5 is cleansing from all sin. You think about the value of the blood of Jesus and the worth of the blood of Jesus, and think of the possibilities in the blood of Jesus. Miracle. M for mercy. I for inheritance. R for redemption. And A for atonement. C for cleansing. In 1 John chapter 1. 1 John chapter 1. And here is what the blood of Jesus Christ does for us. In 1 John chapter 1 verse 7. It says, but if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood, everybody shout the blood. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. The blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. Look up here for a moment. Somebody has a dirty clothes, and he wants this clothes to be clean, as white as snow, and whiter than snow. And he says, you know, I'm going to wash this cloth. I'm going to wash it white. And he tries. He brings water, a bucket of water, and he puts it there, and he squeezes, and he squeezes. He looks at it. All the stains are still there. And then he tries again, and he squeezes in his own strength, in his own power, and the stains are still there. And somebody says, what are you trying to do? He says, I'm trying to wash this cloth, and I want it to be as white can be. And then, how are you doing it? He says, I am, you know, putting all this, look at all this water, and the scene is not being cleaned. And the fellow said, step aside, and he takes that cloth from him, and he puts detergent inside the water. And without any effort at all, he puts it in like that, just rinses, and he brings it out. Hey, the thing is white. I said the thing is white. What you are trying to do by yourself, you cannot clean up your life by yourself. I will try, I will struggle, I will not tell you, I vow, I'm not going to do this, I'm not going to do that. All that is trying, it doesn't bring the blood of Jesus in. And I'm saying, what are you trying to do? Somebody says, I'm trying to be clean, I'm trying to be holy, I'm trying to be righteous. Are you trying that? I'm trying to turn over a new leaf. It will not work. But the blood of Jesus comes over your soul, and you'll be clean, and you'll be pure. Because it says, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from what? All sin, all sin. Look at verse 9. It says in verse 9, in that first John, verse 9, but if we confess our sin, that's all you do, that's all you do. If we confess our sin, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Your day has come. If you're feeling guilty about anything, you know, it's not by crying, it's not by saying, oh God, punish me, oh God, do this for me, and that will not take away your sin, but the blood of Jesus, he suffered for you, he shed his blood for you, and the moment you say, I know that blood was shed for me, Lord, I believe, your heart will be clean. He will forgive you. You will have the witness of the Spirit of God in you. He has forgiven me. I'm a new person right now. You have mercy by the blood. You have inheritance by the blood. You have redemption by the blood. You have atonement by the blood. You have cleansing by the blood. You have liberation from sickness. Somebody there, liberation from sickness. I said you have liberation from sickness. He will set you free. I said he will set you free. He sets you free from Satan. He sets you free from sicknesses. He sets you free from evil spirits. And when those evil spirits, when they see you, if you have the mark of the blood of Jesus on you, they cannot cross the bloodline. Sickness cannot cross the bloodline. Infirmity cannot cross the bloodline. It is the blood. It is the blood of Jesus Christ that sets you free. Free from Satan, you'll be free. Free from evil spirits, you'll be free. And free from sicknesses and attacks and affliction, you're free in Jesus' name. Revelation chapter 12. Revelation chapter 12. I'm reading now from verse 11. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. Who did they overcome? They overcame Satan. They overcame the destroyer. They overcame the one that brought sickness. The one that brought disease into the world. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. If you're going to overcome sickness, it's by the blood of the Lamb. Overcome Satan is by the blood of the Lamb. Overcome all those tormenting spirits, it is by the blood of the Lamb. It says that they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. What does that mean? I believe the blood of Jesus cleanses me. I believe the blood of Jesus cures me. I believe the blood of Jesus covers me. I believe the blood of Jesus converts me. I believe the blood of Jesus creates me afresh and anew. It is the blood of Jesus. At the moment you say, yes, Lord, I believe that blood was shed for me, you will be free. I said you will be free, because the blood of Jesus had not lost its power. This is the miracle of the blood of the Lamb, that by stripes you are healed. Let me read from verse 9. You understand? Verse 9, it says, and the great dragon was cast out. That dragon, maybe your family tonight, is cast out. Evil powers cast out. Curses cast out. All those territorial spirits, no, not in your house. I said not in your house. And the dragon, the great dragon, was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceives the whole world. He was cast into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation. Salvation has come. And strength. Strength has come. And the kingdom of our God, and the power, and the power of his Christ. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. Let's make it personal. And we overcome him by the blood of the Lamb. Make it your own. And I overcome him by the blood of the Lamb. The least in the kingdom of God, the youngest in the kingdom of God, will be an overcomer because of Jesus Christ. See what I'm telling you. David looked at Goliath and he said, I come to you in the name of the Lord whom you have defied. And then he threw that thing and he sunk into his head, and Goliath fell down. When Goliath fell down, the youngest Israelite and the youngest recruit of the soldiers in the army that was afraid before, look at Goliath lying down. That youngest and weakest of the armies of Israel can come and walk all over Goliath. I'm saying that Jesus Christ, by his death on the cross of Calvary, Jesus Christ, by the blood he shed, Goliath is falling. The dragon is falling. All the yokes and all the curses are falling. And the youngest of us here, you believe in the blood of the Lamb, you can come and walk over your problem and walk over all your infirmity, because now you're free and you become a conqueror in Jesus' name. You have a sevenfold miracle through the blood of Jesus Christ. And finally, number seven, escape from earthly suffering and eternal suffering. Escape. I see somebody who has escaped there. They will not catch you again. They will try, they will fail. They will fight, they will fall. They won't catch you. I said they won't catch you. Powers of darkness will not catch you. Sickness will not catch you. All their poverty will not catch you. All the curses they throw, they can throw it from the village, they can throw it from the forest, they can throw it from the sea, it will not catch you, because you have escaped. Look at